the studios of Turnstile Records, join us for another exciting installment of
Mixtape Pod.
In an infinite universe of mindless podcasting, only one will reign supreme. And then there's this one.
The Escape Pod.
Come to the Escape Pods.
Is that your robot voice?
Yeah.
Well, I wasn't told I was going to do that in post.
I decided
I
to do
it. Was good.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
Very big welcome to, well,
Timmy Taco.
Jezbot.
Katie, I don't have a name yet. I need a name. I want a cool name.
KT.
Well, Tim did suggest like small K, big T.
Yeah, I did say that, didn't I? Small K, big T.
But punctuation doesn't really work.
No, that's
does
right.
Like, without
just,
the
I
visual.
Just kind of texted it out. That's kind of how it landed, but
not sure. Well, we'll figure it out.
That's along the way, yeah.
But thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for classing up the joint, because the Escape Pod was getting a little bit on the...
Testosterone side?
Yeah, I was going to say, because you're a... What you call it?
A female.
That's the one.
Yeah.
We've never had one of them in here.
Yeah. I think Cass's voice was in the background. And, I mean, we've invited our wives.
Yeah.
We should probably explain where you...
fit in.
Yeah.
To the social circle.
How does that work? I just...
Well, once upon a time, you went to primary school with a bloke. That's where
here
it started.
We go way back.
That's gone back.
So you're his wife. Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. And we've been hanging out for numerous
years.
Yeah.
It's good times.
We just went to your wedding.
I know, right?
And we'll touch on that later with another segment that we all love, Weddicate.
We do have some Weddicate.
So stick around for that one.
Stick around. I think we did invent it at your, I said party before, but I really...
But it was a party.
It
That's
was.
The whole idea.
It was a great wedding. And people would need to learn from your wedding how to do it. That's what I'm saying. How to do it.
How to do the wedding.
The wedding. Yes.
Yeah.
Because I don't remember the part where we had learned how to do it.
Well, I had to learn how to do it.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, because
it was your first time.
Well, it was my first wedding. And I don't know. Right. It doesn't come naturally.
Okay. Well...
Yeah. Yeah,
everything in nature's
just a party with a couple of
just a few.
No, but you got there's
few
so
bows.
Many so many years before that big day, planning like throwing good parties.
Yeah, that's right.
Knowing how to be at a party, what your guests like.
It's true.
Who your guests are,
who likes you,
who's invited.
Yeah, that's big. Where do they sit?
No drainers. No drainers at a wedding.
No.
No.
Oh, you had a free for all, didn't you?
What do you mean
for the seating?
Yeah, so you didn't get stuck next to anyone.
But then if you didn't sit down fast enough, you got stuck with someone.
Is that what you said?
Because there was
Jeremy.
Well, there was no one to be stuck by.
Yeah,
at your wedding, it was a good mix.
Good mix.
Mix at the lovely Flippity Sticks estate.
And I've got a question from the old soundboard for you. Are you ready?
Yep.
You ever seen a grown man naked?
Strangely, yes. Yeah, the wedding night, yeah.
What about...
Do you ever hang around the gymnasium?
No, not at the wedding.
No,
although we did the next day. There was a gymnasium there.
It was.
Okay. Mm, we did
like
that.
Movies about gladiators?
Russell Crowe? No. Yeah. No.
I reckon... it's another gladiator movie.
I don't know.
Is there gladiator movies? Oh, the gladiators.
Oh, the 300?
No, it was quite big in the 80s. Did you...
What kind of movies were you
watching in the 80s?
What was it? My Little Pony was one of them that was big on the rotation.
Right.
Because in the 80s, Jeremy and I were watching, you got your Barbarians, you got your Commandos.
You got your Terminators.
You got your
Rambos.
You did?
Yeah. Anything slightly sciencey was up there. But also, you know, Care Bears. That was huge.
We talked Star Wars, Star Trek.
Yeah, I did. Not so much Star Trek.
That's
Star
fair enough.
Star Wars,
yeah.
quite okay.
Yeah.
Sure, if you asked Jeremy to watch Star Trek with you, watch it all again.
Well, I probably would if we don't have a Star Trek night every Thursday. We could do a tight 3 hours of episodes back to back.
Tight 3 hours?
Yeah.
Aren't they like 2.5 hours long?
Well, they go for about 45. You'll get three in. I'll fall asleep. Sure, snooze factor of about 9.7.
Yeah.
Excellent.
I'm going to fall asleep. You'll be sitting there watching it by yourself.
Great.
Wake up and then MASH is on.
So, a quick Pfeffernuss. Hit us up on turnstilerecords.com. Audio beam. Facebook, why don't you? And
no, Twitter.
And if you don't know by now, check the previous episodes.
Yeah. That's really? It.
That's
Bing.
It.
Bing.
Oh, wait,
Tim, you got
a... Have I got a Bing? Mm. Close enough.
Jeepers.
That's slightly off key Bing.
Yeah. That'll do it. That's
better.
Much better.
Yeah.
Tim.
My coffee. Didn't have a good coffee.
Right.
Didn't have a good coffee.
It's the worst. It's what you need in the morning. First up.
I want to sort of say it's partly Jazzbot's fault.
I'll take it already. It's probably my fault.
It wasn't recently, but I did remember it today because I had a similar incident, which reminded me, but I'll tell you about this incident.
Right.
Jeremy sometimes does work in and around our house and always demands regular coffees on the regular.
That's fair enough, isn't it? When you're working
Are you working for free? Yeah, absolutely.
On your time.
And we left the cup outside and I've gone around and rounded up all the cups, chucked them in the dishwasher, and Bob's your uncle. Great.
Good.
Maybe a week later, I've emptied the dishwasher. It's everything's away. I'm going back around to the second lot of circulation of, you know, I've got up to the clean stuff that I'd previously cleaned, made myself a coffee, and then took a couple sips, and then I looked down, and then an earwig is floating.
I love it.
Right? I go, that's disgusting, that's disgusting. So I've like... put it down, stirred it, and three more came up. Three more earwigs.
Yeah. Why is it my fault?
So
because it must have been stuck in the goos left in the bottom of your cup outside. Mm-hmm. Then I've dishwashed it. The dishwasher failed me. I've put them back in the cupboard upside downsies, made a coffee blindly. Earwigs.
It's a lot of...
I want to submit an alternate theory here. How do you know the earwigs weren't in the coffee? In
because
the container.
When I gave it,
contaminated
because
coffee.
Because surely, like, dishwasher.
Are you talking about a contaminated coffee cup?
No, the actual coffee jar. Ooh. How do you know?
Because, well...
Isn't there more chance of that than it surviving
I use a,
the dishwasher?
A contaminated coffee container.
I use
or
coffee
you've
machine,
left it outside.
Coffee machine.
Like pods.
Like flippity stick pods.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So it couldn't be that. It couldn't be that. My dishwasher failed.
Yes, I'll take the blame.
But just going on from that, a little coffee fact, because I looked that up. I thought, has anybody else in the internet suffered the same consequences as I have? And I came across something.
Earwigs.
Not so much earwigs, but that's the fact that most pre-ground coffee has grounded cockroaches in it.
Yep.
Are they Colombian cockroaches?
Don't know.
Where is it ground?
Crushed.
Is it ground here?
It's not such a industry secret. According to the FDA's own studies, up to 10% and often more of green coffee beans are insect infested.
Wow.
According to Dr. Emlyn, they can be they can't be processed out, so they simply get roasted with the beans and ground up into them. So when they make them,
and that's your protein for the day.
Yeah, that's your sure. That's your the big coffee tins. So you got your office supply.
Yeah, like the
tins,
massive
the big,
catering
the big bulk.
The bulk
I'm
style.
I'm hearing a lot of C's, catering coffee containers.
Mm. Yeah, and...
Containing... Well,
there's nothing they can do about it. It gets ground up.
It's just up in there.
I'm sure there is something.
More
sterile... I feel like they're not trying hard enough.
Yeah.
Like, you don't get your appendix taken out and they go, oh, by the way, there's some cockroaches. Couldn't get them out of the operating
theater.
Full of
earwigs.
We just left them in there.
Yeah.
Just sewed it up.
Now,
and my keys are in there too, so.
Recovery might take a while. Yeah. We found some earwigs and some cockroaches up in you.
That's called foreign body. That's what that is. Foreign body.
Mm. Mm. And how many percentile factoids do they let into your body after surgery?
Well, zero. That's why I'm saying they can control the coffee.
Zero. Right.
If they can control that, they can control the
coffee. I've been seeing the
Isn't
wrong
that the
doctor.
First question on your surgery exam?
Yeah. How many contaminants are you allowed
in? A, none. B, some.
Some no, can't be a doctor.
Cockroaches.
You've got to be a vet if you do bee.
Let me just plug back in.
You right there?
Yeah, I'm right. So
coffee, my earwig coffee may very well have contained earwigs and cockroaches.
And you're
but
no
it's
worse.
But a pod. Aren't you saying that pods are better? They're more sterile.
It was a pod.
Maybe that's the way to go.
The escape pod's better.
Oh,
look what
look
you did
there.
Look
at that.
I see what you did there.
That was nice work.
How do you feel about coffee?
Well, I do have a question. I've got this issue happening at the moment. So, been at work for a while now. Yeah. And
new job,
but been there for a month. And on the first day, you know, you've got to figure out where to get your coffee. That's your thing.
Where's your spot? Yeah.
So it's in Collins Street. So, you know, there's a lot there. You've got to really suss it out. So been going to the same guy once, maybe twice a day for a month. He knows my name. Like, oh, hi, Kate. How's your day? What's been going on? How's work? Yep. Don't know his name.
Oh.
Can't figure out how to, like, hi, this is awkward. Like, you know, my date of birth, where I holiday.
What's this guy look like?
Well,
let's try and work out what
he's
doing.
Wait, I'll tell you what it looks like.
Okay, right. Okay, I'll tell stereotype you. Come on.
Okay, so he's a barista.
He's a barista.
Oh, this is going to halve our audience. He has definitely a piercing that you can see.
Okay, so no. I'm gonna take guess. No. He definitely has a tight.
This is like Guess Who, you know, with the little things. Like,
okay, cool. Let's play Guess Who, Barista.
Yeah.
Does he have a face piercing?
No.
Okay. Does he have a tight black t-shirt on?
No, he's a hoodies man. He wears hoodies.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do the hoodies have sleeves?
Well, yeah.
I'm out.
Does he have a beard?
No, clean shaven.
Clean shaven.
Mm.
Is this really a coffee shop?
It's like, I think it's like a yuppie, because it's Collins Street. It's a Paris end of Collins Street. So it's like a yuppie.
Was there anyone else on the staff looking hipstery?
Nah. No. So
clean
I think
cut.
It's...
Oh, Collins Street. It's Collins Street.
Yeah.
We're in the
yeah.
wrong spot.
It's Collins Street.
It's the Wall Street of Collins Street.
But my issue is as well, I said to, you know, my little work colleagues and things, I'm like, what's the coffee guy's name? Oh, we don't know. They've worked there for years.
No one knows him. So he's the kind of guy that's...
He's a stalker.
No, he owns the place.
He owns the place. Yeah. Is it Barry's Coffee House?
I think it's like a one syllable, like a John or Dom. Or John.
Hey, you.
Roy. Awesome. But, like, how do you do it?
Well,
do I now go up to him and say, and just be honest, and go, I'm really sorry.
I would change coffee shops.
And walk in first day and go, hi, my name's Kate. I'm a latte drinker, no sugar. What's your name?
Yeah.
Is that how you do it?
I think so. I think you've got to put it out there.
You're going to go on a date with him if you go with that approach, pretty sure. That pretty much tells
are you
a dog
man or a cat man? Because if you're a cat man, I can't get my coffee here anymore.
Do you like long walks on the beach?
Yeah.
Do you like sunsets?
Pina coladas.
I think he's he's doing that retail.
What do you mean? Of course he's doing it. He is in retail.
Oh, he looks so good in that.
No, he's not sleazy.
You should buy that.
Yeah. Oh, my God, Katie, how have you been? How is your thing? They remember things so that you go there.
Oh, yeah, because you feel like you're home. Some days I like hanging out there better than I do in my own workplace.
Well, this might go out, too.
And that's what...
You miss a video.
No, I love my job. I love my job.
Of course.
So good.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I just don't know. Like,
so how do you do it?
Ask him.
No. How else can you do it without asking?
What my other plan was to pull one of the other people aside who works there and go, what's his name?
Like, what about the old, do you guys have a business card?
Oh, business. They do. It's Engels Coffee House.
Maybe his name is
called Engels.
Am I allowed to brand, like... I'm giving him a plug.
But now he knows that you don't know his name.
We've just figured it out.
Okay. Yeah. That's how we're going to do it.
Okay.
He can tweet us in at
At Escape Podders.
Yeah.
If you're a barista,
If it's Ingles.
And you're,
Just say yes. If your name is Ingles.
Say nothing.
That's right.
Yeah. Don't say anything.
Yeah.
If, only if your name's, what was it? Ingalls.
I think that's what we're going with.
Yeah. So maybe I just start calling him Ingalls. I'm just calling him mate at the moment. Hey, mate.
Why don't you call him, like, Mr. Coffee Man? Or like, hey, coffee.
Or you walk in, you go, latte one. And then he goes, barista man.
Who does that?
No one does.
No one. No.
I don't know.
You're really going
out on
a limb.
I think it was the pointing at yourself action that confused me.
Yeah.
One has two thumbs and points at himself.
Last I would two.
Yeah. No. Yeah. So I don't know.
Well,
yeah,
coffee's crazy. No. I'm always getting coffees, yeah. And I get coffees from a lot.
Names or not knowing names.
Not knowing names.
Yep.
Really?
I deliberately go out of my way to not use. Actually, come to think of it, I deliberately go out of my way to not use certain words in texts or emails.
Why? Mm-hmm.
Just in case I spell them wrong.
Like what? No, what?
Yeah.
What?
Let's just say I want to say use like a thesaurus-y word.
Yes, sure.
Or a word that's alternate to the, you know, the simple way of saying things. I want to describe it in the
spice
way.
Spice it up a bit.
Are like you like a Pacific man? Like I specifically asked you.
No, I don't say
like
Pacific.
That.
Unless I'm speaking about the ocean.
It's a valid question.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Well, we need to know where we stand, Katie.
Yeah, that's
true.
You know. That's right.
No, but I don't want to go. You don't want to come across that you're saying something intelligent in the text. You texting away, and then you can't get the spelling.
Okay,
for
there, and there. You don't want to fuck that one up.
No, because you'll be ridiculed on social.
You don't want to throw a word in.
Yeah. Two, two, two.
You don't want to throw a smart word in and spell it wrong. You don't want to do that, do you?
No.
It's like, look at this guy over here. He's trying to spell.
He's trying to spell there over there.
He's trying to spell alphabet. This Gerald doesn't even know how to do that. I've got, just staying on the coffee tip for a minute.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cool, yeah.
I have some multiple choice questions.
Oh, cool.
Are we up? We're up.
Is it? Can we get a sound effect up in there? Oh, can we mention the new member
the
of the board? Escape? Yeah.
You can do that. I've just got to
really
trigger pad next to me.
This, I can't believe it's taken 20-odd episodes to get the effects board happening.
Oh, very nice, but not what I'm looking for. There it is. There he is.
There he is. Okay, the name cappuccino comes from
cappuccino.
No, that's cappuccino.
The name cappuccino.
Cup of chino
comes from
what?
A.
Wait. How is it pronounced?
Cappuccino. Am I supposed to say cappuccino?
Is that how you said it the first time?
I don't know, probably.
I'm going to listen back to this episode and find out how you actually said that the first time, because it wasn't...
There it is.
The name cappuccino. Is that okay?
Yes.
Comes from A. The drink's resemblance to the brown cowls worn by the Capuchin monks. B.
I thought you meant brown cows.
The brown...
Sorry.
The towels.
Oh.
I guess okay. I mean the brown hoods.
Like the robes. Yeah. Yeah. I thought you meant the...
Batman Sorry. Wears a cowl. Continue. It's the cowl of, you know...
Yeah, I always think of that when I hear cowl. I think
it's a cowl.
It's got a silent L in it. Is that what's happening?
I can see the L. I can see it.
You can
it's
see
not
it.
Invisible.
No,
but
it might
be
silent.
Yeah,
okay.
B, the similarity in colour... to the fur of the Capuchin monkeys. Or
is that
the Italian puccino, meaning light brown one.
To Capuchin. That's my bad.
What is that? Look, it's Simon Dale from the Stees.
Let's go in.
Put him up to the microphone
and
see if he's got something interesting to say to us.
I'll just put you on loudspeaker. Simon Dale, you've just... you're in the escape pod, mate.
Oh, yeah, we don't want you in here anymore. You can't hear me.
Can you give us just one little, like, a word of wisdom, something you've learned today or this week?
You're on the air.
Word of wisdom? Okay. don't really know. You put me on the spot. Carl, what do you say to a woman with two black eyes?
What's that?
What?
Nothing, you've already told her twice.
Okay.
Well, okay. Well, right. Yeah. We'll be back next week with Simon. We'll see you soon, mate. Cheerio.
Great. Good
okay.
To hear
yeah. Good for a call in. Gee. Yeah. Sorry about that, guys. I thought I was in silent.
So you got your cowl.
Yep.
Your brown cowls of the monks.
Yes.
You've got your of the Capuchin monks.
Mm.
Or Capuchin.
It's monks. The same place, isn't it?
Okay, I guess so. The colour of the fur on the Capuchin monkeys, or it means, in Italian, puccino, light brown one.
I think it's the, did you say, isn't that a mushroom? A puccino?
Monkey.
No, that was, answer B, puccino.
Little. The B was, the fur of the monkeys.
No, but there's no monkeys in Italy, and doesn't the cappuccino come from Italy?
Okay, she's breaking it down.
Okay, yeah. I'll say.
Given that the old school
I'm
logic.
I'm going C. I'm doing this to you. Yeah. I'm going C.
Yeah.
Two fingers for C.
Yeah. No, I'm going C.
You're going for the light brown one.
I'm saying dates back to sort of, you know, Renaissance-y time where people would be wearing cowls and they'd be getting up and they'd be having their cappuccinos and their lattes and stuff. I'm going. It was invented in a monastery some monk did it.
Correct.
Oh,
it was.
Really?
We've gone with the monks. So
that's quite.
Did they get these guys to crush the beans or
with their cockroaches from the? No.
Like, well, who looks at these beans
don't have enough cockroaches up in here.
You know what those
coffee beans?
Those coffee beans look like? They look like monks, the brown cows on a monk.
Well, you know,
maybe they were bad. They were bad at naming
the first
stuff.
Barista to make their cappuccino.
Yeah,
he wanted that monk money. He wanted to get the monks in to his cafe. So he's like, oh, I've got to name it. I've got to name it something. You know how sometimes people will name a hamburger
the Great Texan. What about,
thank you.
Yeah. Okay, what about the pizza? A Leo di Capricciosa.
Oh, exactly. No.
Thank you. Boom.
That's awesome.
That'll get Leo in.
I want to do a movie-themed pizza store. I've only got one pizza so far. Leonardo di Capricciosa.
So that's where we're at with the coffee. Keep going. We've got another one.
What about Hawaiian 5-0? There's another pizza.
Boom.
It is.
Yeah.
Hawaiian 5-0.
Yeah. Oh, that's a series. Sorry.
Yeah, I'm going to go with
TV or film. TV or film. Kojak. It's a lollipop pizza.
I thought it was going to be full of dog.
Why?
We can't sell that.
Kojak?
Cujo.
That's Cujo. But I was thinking the same thing.
It's got white foam all over the top of it.
Because of rabies. Sour cream.
Because of the rabies.
Yeah.
Because of the rabies.
Okay. Coffee was the first food to be A. Shipped from Europe to the New World.
No.
B. Freeze dried. Used in Aztec religious ceremony.
There's a D.
Oh, wait. Okay.
Roasted and ground up with cockroaches for drinking.
D.
We know it is D.
C.
Going in the C.
Yeah.
Used in Aztec ceremony.
It's quite obvious.
I forgot. No, that's supposed to be. Ba-bom. I should have got that. No whammies.
Well, we both chose we're wrong.
Yeah.
It was freeze-dried.
It was
first.
Oh, really?
First food to be freeze-dried. Would we classify it as food?
How do they know that they weren't...
a coffee sandwich?
You can digest it. I don't know.
How do they know that the Aztecs weren't using it?
Well, you guys went with the Aztecs because of that stupid...
No, not coffee.
You guys got bamboozled by that stupid ad on television.
Which one?
The one with the guys with the... Was
throwing
that the
balls in
was
the
that
air?
The chocolate? No, they were holding out the beans and. Jesus, I haven't even seen it.
Sorry, dude.
I guess you didn't get bamboozled by that.
I didn't.
And there you go.
Right.
Cool.
Jeremy won.
Should I run some coffee outro music?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
I'll put it right here.
Way
down among Brazilians, coffee beans grow by the billions, so they've got to find those extra cups to fill. They've got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. That was that thing. Yeah.
Yeah, you
nice
like that
music.
One?
Yeah.
I did want to mention as a back pheffleness that our loyal listener Matty Whelan has claimed the hoodie from the Lost
black hoodie
and Found.
From the Lost and Found.
Mm.
Yeah, or from all the way overseas. It seems strange that he keeps winning everything and doing it. It's like he's the only person listening apart from her mother.
Yeah, it is a little bit like that. Mm. It's probably true.
Maybe you need to have like some sort of quiz that only your mother or Matt, you know, to
don't know about.
Yeah,
they don't know about or they do know about.
Well, maybe so they do look a bit of a. Well, it's got to be one or the other. Yeah. Okay.
Do you know what we should do?
Yeah.
We should spin that wheel.
You want to spin the wheel?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right, give the wheel a spin. All right,
here we go.
That's the segment we started last week.
This is going to decide what game we're going to play.
Okay.
All right, so go.
Lucky. Okay, here we go.
It's the lucky color.
I can't see what color it is. It is green.
Green. All right, so look on the corresponding list of
topics and...
Here we go. I'll just pull that up there. Yes. What have you got?
We have ye olde sayings.
Ye olde sayings.
Is that Aldi? Are you saying the Aldi? The Aldi sayings. Is that right?
Ye olde sayings.
You need my phone.
Five for $2 or three for... 10. I don't know.
I don't know how it works.
Yeah, no.
So we'll need to edit this because I need to.
Oh, you're pulling up the file now. Should I give you a little bit of a?
They say, see a broad to get that booty ack 'em, leg her down and smack 'em, yak 'em. Cold got to be. Yo, shit.
There you go, laying down some slang for y'all.
So, Katie, we often talk, and Tim and I are around, we often. Very loose in the meanings of words.
Yep.
There's a lot of...
Loose-lipped.
Loose-lipped. We use a lot of slang. We use a lot of...
Catchphrases.
You've got your... sayings. Pop culture. Anyway. So I thought maybe we should see if we can get on the same page.
Sure. Yep.
And see if you know what we're talking about. So I went on to... Urban Dictionary to start her off.
Yeah.
I found your name actually.
Oh, yeah.
Katie.
Mm.
A happy person who is a good listener and a reliable friend, likes to party and is always there when you need her. Oh. Call Katie. She'll go out.
Oh my God. Ooh. This
is
like. Is
there a number there?
It is.
Could you not give my number out? Like,
no,
I won't.
I'm
married now.
For a good time. Call Katie.
Yeah.
But it was posted by a Katie. Oh. It's posted by Katie A. Right. August 11, 2006.
So
Oh yeah.
It wasn't copied off the back of a toilet door.
No, that wasn't.
Okay, that's good. Mm. That's good.
But all true. So everything on Urban Dictionary must be true then.
Or yeah. every Kate that posts up about themselves is the same.
It's full of themselves.
What would you say? I've never used this, but I thought it was pretty funny.
Right. Okay.
Shavocado.
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 Would that mean?
What does it mean?
What do you think?
Shavocado would have to be shaving yourself with the rind of an avocado.
It's pretty close, I guess.
I thought it might be a haircut.
You put it together? You're totally right.
Oh, really?
You're totally right.
It's a shaved scrotum of an adult male.
Okay.
Or male.
A shavocado.
Shavocado.
You can tell Johnny was quite proud of his shavocado as he entered the locker room showers.
Can you take a screen print of that and text it to my friend John, please? Not my dad. That would be weird.
John's got a shavocado.
I'm guessing John is the kind of man who might have a shavocado.
He's got a shavocado sort of.
Yeah, he's got that vibe. Well, the walk about him.
What about Spange.
A spange? Oh.
It's like sponge.
It's not like sponge. What's sponge?
What are you, well, this, I'll tell you later.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I'll tell you, you I'll look it up. On a, I'll look then, it up. Yeah, look up sponge.
It's spare change.
Oh.
Say it again.
Spange.
Spange.
Oh.
Like change.
What do kids used to call change. It? Kids at school used to call it poo change.
Yeah.
Or church, as as Paulie calls it, Paulie D.
Because you give it out at church.
Well, it's you collect your loose change. And
you got
it's your church.
Church
money.
You got any church?
It's got any church?
Got any church? Just use I like that.
I'll get you a coffee. This is how it's. I'll go get you a coffee, boss. Got any money? Yeah, some church in my center console.
I dig it. So, the first time you went to the center console to look for church, what did you think you were looking for?
I was also looking at the same time for a left-handed screwdriver.
Right. Yeah.
Yep.
Can you go to my car and get the pen out of the glove box?
He said that to me.
Me once. Upside down pen. What's that? It's a pencil.
Upside down.
What about crotch spiders?
Crotch spiders, I'd say that's crabs.
Crabs.
Yeah, it's got to be.
It's not. It's not. What? You would. You would think that.
Crabs.
It's got to be crotch spiders. It's got to be.
Think of my crotch.
Well.
Then.
Hideous smells, wafting, wavy. I was thinking of your crotch. Sorry.
My crotch. Yeah.
Yeah.
Crotch spiders.
Things got weird.
Do you want to have a crack?
Things got weird.
Do you want to have a crack at crotch spiders?
I don't know. I thought it would be crabs. It's the only logical.
It's the pubic hair that sneaks out of a bikini bottom.
Oh, when are you wearing your bikini bottom?
You know,
man,
strictly for comfort.
Ooh,
look at that crotch spider on her. Impressive.
That's actually sexist, I want to say.
I'm just
sure
reading
females
from.
Aren't the only people who get crotch
yeah,
spiders.
Yeah, but a dude wrote it.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so then I thought that was some of the.
The sayings we don't use.
Don't use.
Yeah, okay.
No.
What about. Okay, so drop a dime. Could you break, because Tim knows what this one is. This is more going into the hip-hop sort of...
To drop a dime.
Yes.
What are you doing? What are you doing when you're dropping a dime?
Break it down. See if you can...
Well, okay. Drop a dime. Is it like putting one of those big records thing on your little turntable-y thing? Is that like dropping a dime? Because it's a big circle.
Oh, okay.
You're putting it down.
Yeah, no, that's
you're
pretty
dropping.
Good, man.
You know, like,
we might actually start using
start,
it like that.
You know when you say,
you
like...
You want to drop this dime?
I know, right?
You're
so that
DJ.
Works.
Let's drop this dime.
Again.
Man, we should make that.
I think you should make one of those buttons on there that you can press
it.
Oh,
very nice, but not what I'm looking for.
Okay, next try.
It's,
drop a dime.
Yeah,
drop
so I'll give
like
you a clue.
Paying a homeless man.
Oh, yeah.
Well, she's pretty good, man. Like, she's coming out with a whole bunch of new sayings. It's actually, like, I'll,
yeah.
You know, because there's plenty more.
Mm-hmm.
It's the snitch. So if you want to call up a copper.
Right.
You drop a dime, which
phone.
Is what, 25 cents in the phone, because you're a snitch.
Awesome.
Yeah, you're a rat. You're a rat dog snitch.
Yeah.
That, yeah, okay.
My phone keeps...
I like my record one better.
I don't mind the record one at all. So let's just change that. Urban Dictionary.
Update that on Urban Dictionary.
Killing two pigs with one bird.
Because you say that all the time.
Yeah, no, that's actually a... Angry Birds reference.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no one's ever used that.
All right, what about this one?
Creators of Angry Birds.
Okay, we all know this
marketed
one.
Marketed that,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, they just
slotted
that
sure
in there.
Oh, they sure did.
Yeah.
What's the most delicious food on earth? McDonald's. Just thought I'd let you know.
Okay, I like this.
Fact. What's slang for McDonald's? Yummy.
just digging at.
Go.
Irish goodbye.
What's the word for an Irish goodbye?
No, that's the saying.
Irish
like
goodbye.
What does
Irish
it mean?
Goodbye, vomiting on the footpath.
That's racist.
Yeah.
Is it stereotype?
Stereotype.
Yeah.
Stereotypical.
I feel
it's you don't because you don't want to get like all stereotypical and go.
Well, now I feel like I'm being racist.
Okay. Well, it's leaving quietly out the side door of a party or a bar without saying goodbye to anyone.
No, that's cool. That's ghosting.
That's ghosting.
Mostly
yeah.
due to the fact that the family or friends will most likely take your keys away
Oh, so it's drink driving. So it's drink driving. That's what it is. It's not.
So it's a criminal act.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
All right. So that's something we use and will never use.
Yeah.
But I know, because I dropped a dime on you and said I might be doing some phrases.
Yeah.
You.
So I quickly did a little bit of a scan on the old intranet and came up with a couple of classic slangs from the 1920s. Let's see if we know.
Diggities. Yeah.
Let's see if we know what these ones are. Mm. Do you know what a juice joint is?
Well, it's got to be somewhere you get illegal. So it's bootleg booze, 20 prohibition. So, yep, booze okay. house.
Correct. Yep. Ding. Oh. It's a booze house.
Can we do it in...
I thought that was too obvious.
Or it's, yeah, a speakeasy. It's speakeasy. A speakeasy.
Yeah, yeah. Speakeasy. Do you want to do it in ye olde
accent? Can you
accenting?
Do it in the voice?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
In the 1920s, what is a moll? M-O-L-L. A mole.
A mole.
A mole.
A mole. I reckon that's someone...
I know what it is in their 70s.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's a mole. That's a mole.
And in the 80s, it was a mullet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then in the 2000s, it's a mole so that I've got to get cut out. Got to get it cut off my...
It's a mole.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mole.
I reckon that's something you bash someone with.
Incorrect.
I think it's a person.
Correct.
I what think it might who's? Be like a Nazi informer or something.
Yeah, oh, no, she did.
Is it?
Oh, yes, yeah, she did.
You went there. You went Nazi. No, it's actually a gangster's girlfriend, but I'll pay that. Nazi will do just fine.
Nazi girl. That was not even what I said.
Were there Nazis in the 20s?
Yeah, they were around, but not. They weren't.
Yeah.
Okay, so, okay. Yeah. To be ossified is to be what?
Ossified.
Ossified.
I think you're drunk.
Correct.
What?
To be Scrooged is to be what?
Screwed. No?
Tight. To Scrooged.
To be like a tight ass.
Drunk?
To be...
Correct.
What?
To you be like, spifflicated.
Drunk.
Okay. To be zozzled.
Katie, please.
Look, I'm not really sure.
Take a stab at it.
Is it to be drunk?
Correct.
Yeah.
If you were to say to your friend, but me, what would you be asking for?
How good
for?
A friend are you?
Light your
good friends. Close real friends. Close. Don't tell anybody.
I think but me would be light my cigarette.
Give me a cigarette. I'll pay that. I'll pay that.
I should have been around in the 20s, I tell you. Mm.
When you're saying to your loved one, the bank is closed, what are you not permitting anymore?
Handouts.
Ooh, hello.
Hand jobs.
Hello? Close.
Should sexual acts.
This act should lead to hand jobs at least.
Ooh. Kissing. Canoodling.
Yeah.
Kissing and making out. Correct. Right. And as they would say in the ye olde days, sorry, babe, bank's closed.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Okay.
say, wifey.
Yeah.
I've had a hard day. Bank's closed.
When you have to go see a man about a dog, what are you going to do?
My husband still says that. It means something completely different these days.
Oh, okay.
I think it's...
He also say, I've got an itch to scratch.
No, he doesn't say that.
That's different.
That's different?
Yeah. I think it's...
I reckon...
Back of a truck, dealio.
Yeah, dealio, like illegal alcohol-y kind of...
Well, to go buy whiskey and usually...
Yeah.
The old...
Gotta see a man about a dog, I say.
Say,
where are you going?
I'm going to see a man.
What man?
About a dog.
What dog?
The dog man.
What dog?
Whiskey. I'm buying whiskey. And thought this was funny, just to finish it up here.
Let's do this all night. I want to hear all
No,
of them.
to get a wiggle on. And that's
yeah,
that seems
hurry
to
up,
come
hurry
back.
Up, yeah, hurry up.
Let's get going.
Yeah.
I've got one. It's not from the 20s.
Sweet.
But I've got a friend who drives trucks along the highway.
Mm.
And they've got all these funny little things that they say to each other so people on the radio can't tell. And I learnt...
Duck's got a curb in it.
The
two ducks in a pond.
The Barbie's hot, mate.
Mm.
You've got to say it like that. The Barbie's hot. Mate. Means the weigh bridges are open.
Barbie's hot.
The Barbie tart.
I would have thought that was
police. So what do you do? Do you pull over? You don't want to get weighed.
Well, I don't know. No, you don't want to get weighed because you don't want, I think, your logbook checked and them to find all the pseudoephedrine in your cab.
Oh, yeah. And all the ox blood in your blood system. Yeah.
But he's got a heap of them. And it's like they're talking a different language.
Rubber ducky, rubber ducky, rubber ducky, rubber ducky, rubber ducky, rubber. That's all I know.
What is rubber ducky?
I don't know. Oh. Come here, rubber ducky. That's my code name.
Is it?
Rubber ducky.
Which you don't
know.
No,
we
yet.
Used to get, back in the ye olde days, Cam Barrett used to have a...
Icicle.
Icicle?
That'd be his call sign.
Oh, is that his call sign, Icicle?
It has to be.
Yeah, Icicle.
That was his hip-hop name.
Was it?
Yeah.
What was your hip-hop name?
I'm DJ. Watch my
I thought you were.
Timmy Two Fingers.
Drebs?
No, that wasn't me.
Who was Drebs?
That was Adza.
Oh.
That's to Nichols.
I thought you were... I want to go with your Timmy Ten Hands. No, Timmy Ten Hands, you were...
Timmy Tonal.
Red?
Nah.
Mine was The Burbs, because I was like, well, I live in the suburbs and I can't really...
That was your hip-hop name?
I'm not writing no gangster rap. Up in this nice family.
In like the working class neighborhood that you call home.
Icicle used to have the ham radio.
Yes, he did.
The old
did he?
CB. And I'm pretty sure your neighbors had some crazy aerial business
tower.
Going on.
Yeah. Massive. Is that still tower. There? That got taken down. It was a 30 feet in the air.
What is the deal with aerials?
What is
it
deal?
Because there wasn't the NBN when you were growing up? Is that why they had these aerials?
All CB.
Or were they...
All CB.
Okay. Were they like doomsday preppers?
Looked like a doomsday aerial.
Yeah.
Right.
Definitely.
Okay.
It's like... It was mental. It was so ridiculous at all. So,
and it could rotate.
I've had issues with my neighbours and unsightly things that they've built onto their house, which stick way too far into the air and whatnot. You know, the court case pending. he doesn't know about it yet.
You probably can't talk about it if it's an ongoing legal issue.
That's right.
It's all good. But like I instantly, like he put it up, and I instantly went, right, that's coming down. That's coming down. Right, so. You have a 30-foot aerial next year?
I couldn't do anything. I took photos of it. I watched
it. So you did say...
I actually grew accustomed to it, and I was taking a lot of photos of clouds, if you remember. Do you remember that on my Instagram? Check me out on jbot78 Instagram.
I don't follow you on Instagram.
That's fine. If you would, fine.
Okay.
It's not a bad
You would
bad.
See a lot of cloud shots.
I feel like you may have had the same problem recently with something being erected in your front yard.
Oh, yes. That was
my rage. We did that last.
He had his rage.
Raged out. Mm. Yeah, but that was a good segue.
Mm.
If you're up to date with the escape pods, you'll know that we're not already talking about that.
Keep going. What about the aerial?
I started to grow accustomed to it.
But then
you take photos with it, the clouds coming, and then they just one day it was gone.
Really?
Oh, and do you know what? My speaker, I put ceiling speakers in.
Yeah.
And then randomly, one of the ceiling speakers would just click on,
aliens.
And I could hear.
It's aliens.
Well, of course. Yeah. I put the tinfoil on my
what else
head.
Could it be?
But I could hear CB radio coming through.
Rubber ducky, rubber ducky.
Is it true
it was more like.
It's aliens.
Because
can you pick up baby monitors? Is that myth true? That if you've got the right frequency, you can listen.
They're pretty heavy.
You can
I reckon they're about like 70, 80 kilos.
Yeah.
They're checking the baby's
baby
monitors.
Now,
yeah.
My older brothers had a band in the 80s, and back in the day, it was all tubular. Weird sort of old technology amplifiers and stuff like that.
Yes.
And they were doing a gig, and halfway through their gig, all the sound cut out, and it cut through into all the speakers. CB dudes driving past.
Is that a true story?
same gig. The stage caught fire.
Oh.
Because they had
we got to give them a shout.
Well, they had a light. Pure Indulgence, I think it was. They had a light jammed up into one of those witches hats, and it burst into flames.
Worst gig ever.
Marshall in the house. Yeah,
that's terrible. Pure Indulgence, I think they're coming back.
Are they?
Yeah. I did see a photo of them on Facebook.
Yeah,
I there was some good. Well. Were they costumes, or was that actually what they performed?
That's actually
in?
Them. Yeah,
right. Okay.
That was the 80s. Yeah, is that costumes? That's what you say to your parents. Was it colour back in the olden days?
Yeah.
Were those? Was that perm a wig?
No.
No. No. No.
No. No.
That's
no.
My
no.
Real hair.
What party were you going to?
No party. Why is your hair all permy?
I got a perm.
Yep.
What, you all got a perm?
Yeah.
We all did.
We all got perms.
Yeah. Sorry, I missed
popping
that.
Popping the peas. No, I'm not sorry.
I think you could get a perm.
Well, maybe one day.
You've
I haven't
got
had
locks.
It. I haven't had it. I should probably try it.
Never done a perm?
Never done a perm.
Well, you really should try it.
Oh, sorry, Tim. We
Yeah, you're boring me.
Oh.
Well, I reckon that's pretty good.
No, we've got some more here. We've got some more here. Some questions from the vault.
Ah, the vault. Can we get a sound effect on that, please?
Yeah, I'll put a vault sound in here. There you go. So, I pulled out my flash drive without ejecting it. So, who here? Right, and this kind of defines what kind of person you are.
Yeah.
In these modern times.
Right.
Who ejects USBs properly, or who just rips them out in this room? Are you a ripper?
I am Jack the Ripper.
Do you do the safe eject?
No, I am a Mac user, and they like to shame you on screen.
Oh, they shame you on screen.
They do say, you didn't object. You didn't eject that disc.
Yeah,
like you're a bad Mac mother.
So yeah, I have the same issue. Guilt. I have people in the studio, and they give me their USB, and I put the transfer.
So they're just putting things in and pulling them out.
No. I sometimes just yank it out. And
you're
like,
Jack the Ripper.
I'm a ripper. Yeah, I just want to get rid of people. So that's like
but
the
you've
last
got a Mac.
Thing I need to do.
Doesn't your Mac like
the Mac just gives you a warning? It doesn't really matter, does
it? I feel it shames me to my soul.
Okay, so let me put it this way, right?
Right.
Does it affect your computer, or
no.
Does it affect the USB stick?
Computer.
I would have said USB stick.
Why?
Because you're ripping it out, so it's like.
Oh well, it depends. Are
the
you pulling it?
Corrupting it or something. It's
no.
Not going to wreck your computer.
Because, I don't think it's going to wreck your USB either because
well,
it's done.
I've
you
ripped out 1,000 USBs and nothing has ever
How happened. Many USBs have you ruined?
I have a drawer
Countless.
Full of
USBs. Useless USBs. I wonder how that happened. Well, there you go.
Okay.
So that does define the person.
Okay, so what are you saying, though? How does it define me? You are. I am the type of person that will just...
Okay,
balls deep, run in and... Because I won't jump in to cold water.
He's impatient.
I feel like I am an overthinker, perhaps. That's how that defines me.
I don't want to break this computer I've spent money
like,
on.
But is the computer judging me now?
Oh.
Like,
yeah.
Is my IT guy who gets all my reports from... Like, is he judging
guy.
Me?
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
he is.
I just don't want Scott to judge me.
And then what?
Yeah, I've never seen him face to. I've never seen him face to face.
Scott's
but,
a prick.
Yeah.
But there was a way when we worked at Coles, you used to be able to trick the machines. So there was all this hoo-ha about getting your scan rate up. Get your scan rate up. What's your scan rate? Get your scan rate up.
Oh, because you worked at Coles.
Because we were working at registers, right?
Oh,
this is when we were little tackers.
That's another thing we've done.
So is it like?
So how many items can you get through successfully? Not by, it's like, try to break that record. Do you know what I mean?
Right.
So Mavis on register 13 hit a 2.81 gigawatt scoring range in a scan rate this week. So we found out.
She gets a box of Kinder Surprise broken.
Yeah, box of smash Kinder Surprise, which she put out the back, by the
dented
way.
Soup can.
Can I just take this?
Well, can I just say that? That was the other scam going. Kinder Surprises were very
well,
big.
If you felt like eating tiny teddies, you just go down the aisle, punch a box and go, this one's damaged, and go out the back and just go.
I had half a dozen.
All right.
I used to get into the Yakults.
Did you work
Did
there
you?
As well? You worked at
we
Coles?
We all worked at Coles.
I was a roll girl from Baker's Delight.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Get your rolls.
Wendy's.
Oh,
yeah.
Can I get an oh, yeah, Tim?
Oh, yeah. Sounds like a brand. Oh, I'll take a pack of smack-em-yack-ems and a bread roll. No, and...
love it.
what were we saying? We were saying the scan rate. Rates up. So all you had to do was go, quickly go, like if it was a tray of cat food, you go on 8, and then you'd say 8, and then you'd scan 1. And then that would give you eight hits. 8 hits.
Because I would have thought it would be sloppy if you're trying to race. Like, I don't want someone trying to race and beat their average. I want someone who's stacking and jangering my groceries. I want my eggs to be okay.
I think I was working so quickly one day I fainted.
You went hungover or something from the night before? Was that more to the point?
I woke up in a pool of my own excrement. you know when that happens?
Awesome. Yeah, all the time, every morning.
Just get my scan rate up.
That's Wednesday. You really want your scanners to be up on Tim's tip because because often you'd just go, oh, that one didn't scan, it's already in the bag, I'm not going back.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm not going back for it.
That is true.
Is there a rule, because the only thing I don't feel guilty about is free stuff from the supermarket. So I actually won't say, by the way, that broccoli didn't scan.
I believe in... At one point, I was actually physically saying the word beep.
Beep.
Do you guys take the hydroponic tomatoes? Do you take the green stuff?
The sprig off the top.
Because that weighs.
Do you know what I do? I scan broccolini as broccoli.
Oh,
so I've been caught out once and she went, excuse me, ma'am, that's broccolini. Broccoli.
Is that much?
Yeah, broccoli. I'm dyslexic.
It's actually broccolini. I'm like, it's broccoli. Yeah. And by the end of it, she just thought, I think she just thought I was so stupid that she was like, yes, darling.
You have broken takeover code.
Found out it was the same price.
Yeah.
I'll say.
It's the principle.
My hand up. Admit it. I fill up the bag of nuts at the start.
And eat them slowly.
Oh, you do that? No, that's grapes for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't even get me started on self-serve registers.
Do you know that we shouldn't be doing it because like that whole shopping center stuff, like it's the smallest amount of money you can make per square shopping. What is it? Supermarkets,
yeah.
Per square of...
real estate?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that shelf has to make X amount of money.
I know that they're graded on eye because you want to be on eye level.
But to who? Your short people? Your tall people?
Well, it's all relative, isn't it?
Well, I'm tall, so I want all that good stuff up top.
I want all the goods.
I don't
want
to be bending over to get my goods. Your goods. But then again, I don't do the shopping.
Yeah, I was about to say.
Yeah.
And when I do, I steal. Peanuts.
Yeah, you're a nut thief.
So is there a trail behind you of the shelves? Do you do that?
Your pistachios.
You got your cashews. You
got your Brazilians.
So you get the pre-shelled nuts to eat while you're walking around.
I'm all about that that honey stuff. Anything with a honey glaze on it.
Honey glaze, cashew. Anything. You haven't had those? The sweet...
No.
Mm. You really should try
I like my nuts plain.
Oof.
Hi, Matt.
Oh, no, she did. Oh,
yes, she did.
Yeah.
Somebody wrote in and said, how do I stop over-exaggerating? I do it all the time. It's the worst thing ever.
There you go. It's
thanks,
Dan. I saw what you did there.
Miserable pricks up. Is there a food that you eat that you always use a knife and fork for, even though it doesn't actually require the use of a knife and fork?
Mashed potatoes.
Really? You've got the knife in there as well.
You get the knife in there too. That's true.
You're sectioning it off.
Yeah, man.
Do you make like a little grid
in it? Digging
in
like some, you know, caveman.
Barbarian.
All right, let's put it this way. You're at a work function.
Mm.
You're sitting next to the boss.
Oh,
it's a pizza party.
Oh, I just eat it with my hands. And then I eat off his plate and I eat his pizza. I bet you like science.
Yeah. You lick your fingers and then grab.
I'm sure in the 1920s that meant something else, didn't it?
What? Yeah. What else we got in that 20s?
If you reach off some other man's plate.
Oh, it's really
rude. That's called the Dallas reach around.
What about if you eat another man's nuts?
Oh.
At the supermarket. That's adultery. Right. We'll finish off with a think piece.
Okay, good. Okay. Good, good.
The first person who copied someone was in fact very original.
Oh.
Wow.
He or she
just keeps going around
was
and around,
originally
doesn't it?
Unoriginal.
Oh.
The very first unoriginal original.
Wow. Unoriginal. And was he the chicken or the egg?
Exactly. Exactly.
Who
started it off?
Mm. Can you, when people say it was better than the original, now, can you have better than the original when you can't ever, like,
Coca-Cola.
That's how it was.
Coca-Cola.
It was the best recipe. You can't get. They can't never change.
Oh, no.
Oh, they can change.
It's better
Big
than
Mac.
The original.
A Big Mac.
It was.
I got to say that I've had a Big Mac here, and I know you guys probably don't have McDonald's all that often. McFlippity sticks.
What? Because we're skinny people? Is that what you're saying? You're judging us?
Because you've got nice skin and.
I'm not going down that rabbit hole.
And we went to New York. You really must go.
Thank you.
And
can I get a bing on that?
I'll try and put a little reverb on that so it dings out. And the burgers were better.
I'm disagreeing.
Like I picked the wrong week to quit amphetamines.
Oh, shit.
Did you just say you picked the wrong week?
Like I picked the wrong week to quit amphetamines.
It's like I picked the wrong week to quit amphetamines.
See, I think McDonald's is worse in the States. Slower, colder, greasier.
Yes, yeah. Slower and greasier.
I don't mind an Australian Big Mac.
Australian Big Macs are quite nice.
Mm. All Australian, 100% alien beef. I got
alien
it.
Beef?
Yes.
Yes.
Here's my...
Alien beef.
True.
Here's my conspiracy of the week.
Is there a dun-dun-dun kind of sound?
Well, it's
no?
a new conspiracy.
I want to have something in there.
Conspiracy yeah. that... I've been working on the fact that you see these Facebook posts and YouTube hits and whatnot, and they're pouring like melted, like lead and gold and stuff on the burgers.
Oh, and it's what not setting on, it's not disintegrating
yeah.
and things. Yeah. Bounce,
what do you mean?
Bounces yeah. off it.
Mm. What do you mean?
So lead, melt, like lead.
Like molten lava.
Yeah, like lead or something. Like
yeah.
Not,
what
yeah.
is it called? Yeah, like cast iron when
well,
they
it will not stick to it, burn it.
It does nothing.
What?
I tried shit. This experiment for myself. Mm. I'm going to say circa 2002.
Mm.
So still have pee plates then. But, you know, in the car.
Whoa.
You know, you're going to a club. You're eating McDonald's in the car. You stuff your wrapper underneath the seat.
Yes. Yep.
And you sell the car 3 years later.
Yep.
And the half-eaten burger and the chips.
All the time, you guys.
Resurface.
Is that smell?
Yeah.
No, but it doesn't smell. It doesn't disintegrate. You could literally open it up. It looks exactly the same.
Have a bite.
And,
this has happened in a few cars of mine.
Nickety flippity sticks.
Yeah.
Had a cheeseburger up on his shelf for 3 years and it did nothing. Yep. Did nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So this
it's
is
not
where
food.
The conspiracy starts coming. You're right.
It's
Katie.
Not food.
So, do you remember when they went from styrofoam to cardboard?
Like cardboard.
Like a
more
wrapper.
Sustainability in inverted
with
commas.
And I reckon I would say that's when the taste and the size and everything changed from your ma and pa
multinational.
Went from that to the cardboard wrappers, and the print on the wrapper would say all Australian or all alien beef at the join.
Yeah, so it would go around the wrapper and say
all Australian 100% all Australian beef. 100% all Australian beef. And when it came to the join, it would say 100% all alien. And then the next bit would be beef.
Alien beef.
So that's when they started to... That's when the reptilians were doing their travel. the travel, come to Earth, you know, right. Come and
get
see
a burger.
Get a well. There's nothing to eat for the reptilians. They need some to eat. The tall greys. You get your tall greys.
Where you're going on
you get
this.
Where I'm going?
Oh my god, I'm there.
So,
I'm there
so
already.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna make it on every corner. We gotta put it in every city, no matter where anyone goes. We gotta have a Macca's so that when you're interstellar traveling, you get to go. I know I can eat that molten lava beef because I know it can go into my gut because I've got like what? Not molten lava.
It's I don't know. It's like a new. It's like the new technology.
Well, you've got
maybe
different enzymes
new,
if you're an alien.
Maybe
so, in your
so
tummy.
Are we on board?
I'm on board
maybe,
with this.
Maybe the aliens market it as a super fuel, and we thought it was food.
Yes, that's another thing.
Right, so it doesn't melt at high temperatures.
Okay.
So it's good. It's stable.
So
it doesn't expire.
Yeah,
so it's not going to break
it's
down.
It's not really potato.
It's not really potato. No.
No, sorry. It's not really potato or apple. So your hash browns aren't your hashies.
I might go get an apple pie.
I really love those apple pies.
Let's go get some apple pies. I really want a cheeseburger.
I really want a cheeseburger.
Can't you just put it like on record, like just some loop thing that they keep talking about the same thing?
I can do a, which one is it? I think it's this one.
Now it is time for a break, so let's break.
And then we'll duck down to Flippery Sticks and get some burgers.
Yeah.
And
we're back and we enjoyed
it. Oh, we're back.
Enjoyed it.
Oh, it was delicious. We're back from our break.
And McDonald's is not a big conspiracy for interstellar aliens to have somewhere to eat.
Because we've just supported that theory.
Well, I think in our lifetime, we are going to see the end of it. We will see.
Yeah, I agree. Mm. I actually think that it's on its way out. I think Coca-Cola on its way out.
I think
Amatil. Yeah, they're getting taxed now in the States and the UK, I think.
The sugar tax.
The sugar tax.
I heard about this.
It's coming into Australia
and
as well.
Once you start messing with the original flavour and the original taste and take the sugar out of it.
So I just think that it's on its way out.
And I think they took...
You know what's on its way up? Boost juice. More sugar.
More sugar in it.
Janine also says well. But yeah, more sugar than Coca-Cola. Healthy inverted commas. Yeah.
I still want to be eating the unhealthy mango than the repels lead.
That's true.
Is it
going to
repel your stomach acids?
Your stomach can't get it up in that. It can't break it down.
Mm.
True.
I know that banana is. I know you don't like bananas that much.
Not a big fan.
You're not a big fan.
We've been through this many times.
Yeah.
It's the only fruit that tells the truth. It's the texture.
It doesn't lie.
It's got a day window. There's a lot of things with bananas we don't need to.
Okay.
Rehash.
Hey.
It doesn't have potato in it. The hash browns.
Hash browns don't have potato in them. That's good to know.
Oh, maybe they do. Anyway, we're definitely getting sued this week, and McDonald's, yay.
Yeah, hooray. Yeah. McFlippery Sticks.
McFlippery.
Well, is that the music
might be,
coming up?
Is that,
I can hear the music coming up.
Can you hear that?
I can hear it. Yep, there it is.
Would like to say a warm welcome, a round of applause, a big thanks.
I don't have a round of applause on my soundboard.
You should do it yourselves. I want to hear.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
And a big thank you, and you're welcome back every every
thanks
time.
Thanks for having me.
Every time.
It's been fun.
What a pisser.
Jezbot.
Timmy Tucker.
Still don't have a call sign.
Weekend.
Yeah.
Small K Big T.
Small K Big T.
Pressing the self-destruct button. The ship will self-destruct in exactly 2 minutes and 45 seconds.
The escape pod. What if there are droids in the escape pod? The sensors wouldn't pick them up.
The escape pod is really nice.
Well, boys, it's a very lovely ship. I think you should look out. Goodbye.